Sagittarius. Sagittarius, this is all about you. This is your weekly oracle and tarot card reading from Born Without Boundaries. Weekly predictions, general energies. So Sagittarius, sun, moon, rising, Venus, Mars, Mercury, wherever Sagittarius influences your natal chart, you can apply these energies for the next 7 days. And you should always check out your moon and your rising sign as well as your sun sign, because really your sun sign does not, I mean, it influences all of you, but it doesn't describe all of you. Do you know what I'm saying? So always be really aware of what your rising and moon sign are doing, at least, okay? And if you want to know how you're going to be emotionally affected day by day, check out your moon sign. Okay, Sagittarius. So this is your oracle card spread. We're going to go deep into the energies and then dive even deeper and articulate this reading with tarot in the extended if you want to go a little bit further and get a continuation and a deeper understanding of the reading. That link is below and it includes a romance reading. So let's go. Let's do this, Sagittarius. First, what's your crowning energy, Sag? What's your crowning energy? That will be the energy influencing this entire reading. And here it comes. We have co-create with spirit and open to infinite possibilities. But open to infinite possibilities was flipped upside down at the same time. I don't think it is. This is the bottom line is, it's I think that you have really started to make spiritual connection and communicate, like spiritual connection, to be a more important part of your life. It's actually influencing you more, guiding you more. There's something in your life that you've had to depend and lean on spirituality a lot more. You've listened to its voice. You've found your intuition. There's a sense of giving over to what you can't control. Eight, there's a sense of destiny here. 7 + 1 = 8. So this is the energy of something is destined to be. Maybe you felt this coming, or maybe you haven't felt it coming, and now the truth is finally coming out. Spirit is finally coming, or the truth is finally coming out. 5 + 9 = 4. 4, this is 5. There's changes happening. Changes happening for the better. Changes happening to rebalance things and readjust things in your life. So Sagittarius, I would not fear, if things have been a little bit murky and awry, I think that they're going to start stabilizing themselves and you're going to get a lot of breakthroughs, a lot of potential, a lot of opportunities are going to finally come through. And I feel like these opportunities are ones that have sort of been held back or held away from you for some reason. I don't know about the reason. We'll figure it out. Either here or in the tarot, it'll come out. But this is definitely the energy of what you did to help break through. And that is you reconnected with spirit and you were just like, spirit, take the wheel. Because in other words, you sort of let your mind be opened and you sort of let your mind be expanded in the Aquarius season, because this is Aquarius energy. So you let your mind be broadened and opened and decided that you didn't know what you didn't know and you just let go. And I feel like because of that, spirit has more ways to talk to you. It could be talking to you in very interesting ways that aren't normally things that you would have picked up. But like I said, there seems to be a deeper connection to the spiritual world this week, listening to more quiet things, to signs and symbols, to synchronicities. They'll mean more to you. I don't think you'll even have to try. I think it will get to you. Something will finally get through to you that way. But honestly, they're also sort of finally reaching you. So it's not just a deeper connection to the spirit world. And I don't mean to diminish that. I don't think that that's just anything, because it's a big thing. But what I want to impress upon you, Sagittarius, is that this deeper connection to the spiritual world and this relinquishing of control has allowed your mind to broaden and open. And because of that, real 3D opportunities are opening up for you that you just may not have seen or been interested in before. All right, let's look at the rest of this reading, yo. Ooh, a mask is falling off and the dead are coming out. This is relinquishing the past. Something that was hidden or something that had been pretending, something that had been false is getting revealed, and that's the truth coming out. There's something about maybe trying to pretend like everything was okay when it wasn't, hide the pain. Oh, no. This is like the zombies are walking kind of energy. This is like letting the dead be dead by acknowledging the fact that they're there. Yeah, nothing's being hidden anymore. And like I said, this is divine timing. This is destiny. This is when it was supposed to happen. So especially if it comes back during Mercury retrograde, I think it's coming back around for the last time. This is sort of a breakthrough moment where you won't have to deal with something that keeps haunting you, something that keeps chasing you. There's an energy of finally putting that to rest. Wombat, be at home. Something that may have been attacking your heart space, may have been making you feel uncomfortable, like you weren't at home, even in your own home. Something that may have been making your home be more tumultuous or unsettled. It's those kind of things that are toppling over and comeuppance, is happening this coming week. That's really interesting. I just don't think you're going to feel very comfortable. For the most part, 6 + 8 = 14. That's more change in, I think, more change to your home, towards something toward the heart space. More change is coming. This and that are true. This is saying, first of all, this is really liberating energy, really fun and playful energy. This is also saying, this is your central energy. So it's like, you're going to stay on top of things. You're not going to get bogged down. You're not going to get pulled down. You're going to stay away from the craziness and the chaos of it all, letting it resolve itself. This is, I guess, something that you have to step away from, knowing that you don't, like, every time you try to take control of it, it just takes control of you. So you're not going to deal with that. You're just going to stay sort of in the shallows and try to sort of stay that medium gray area to really try to figure things out and let things peter out themselves. This is almost like, well, then get out of the way. I'm just going to get out of the way of this because I'm going to get out of the way of this because I don't know what I'm doing here. Because if I try to control it, I'm going to mess things up. It's almost like, you know that already. That's a lesson that you already learned, the Sagittarius. So this is just the energy of you trying to stay out of it, or trying to like wash your hands free of it, or finally being liberated from it, at least emotionally. It could very well be that you just realize the ridiculousness of it. You just realize sort of the pettiness or the shallowness of it, the thing that it just keeps trying to come back because it's a dead thing that needs to like keep coming back. This is like, it's not your fault and it's not even your demon. It's just its own thing that, yeah, it's like you see the truth of it. You see the truth finally, and it kind of liberates you from caring so much. Let spirit be your guide. This is that aerial perspective, and this is also co-create with spirit. So I really do, I don't know if you're praying a lot, Sagittarius, or you're meditating a lot, maybe you're doing yoga, whatever you're doing that's bringing you closer to a sense of peace and calm and relinquishing. You are literally just letting go and you're all into this Mercury retrograde. You're diving in big time. You're just going to stay at the surface and let the flow happen to you. And almost like you're standing back and saying, not me. It's not on me. I didn't make these decisions, and don't put this on me. But it's more than that. It's almost like, spirit, take the wheel, because I'm not going to be caught up in this craziness and this chaos. It's just not the place for me. Let spirit be your guide. Taking an objective perspective for a change. 3 + 2 is the energy of 5. So you're actually changing your tune, and you're removing yourself from the situation. I'm telling you right now, this is about not taking things so personally. Because it's wreaking havoc on your house to take it personally, and you're just done with that. You're done. Scarab beetle energy, once again, is flipped upside down. So this has to deal with magic works through you. I almost feel like you are working magic on a situation, or you've tried to work magic on a situation before, you've tried to be the conduit before, and it really failed you and backlashed. It ended up hurting you or getting you into a bad situation or burying you. This is the energy, a Cancerian energy, but it's almost like not being able to make the connections that you want to make. And maybe trying to understand why. And by taking that perspective, that objective perspective, and removing the emotions from the situation, Sagittarius, you're able to gain some clarity and make some breakthroughs. Let it shine. This is Scorpio energy coming through. So this could be female energy, mother energy, that's kind of like just defeated you. This is more masculine energy coming through, spotlighting you, determination and finding a way forward, finding a direction, and honestly, finally being heard. And I think you're finally able to be heard because you're not speaking from emotion. You're speaking from understanding. You're speaking from an objective insight. That's what you're doing. It's almost like you're connecting to spirit to get their radio waves and see what spirit sees, so that you're being more objective and more people are able to listen to you because of it. It's also finally realizing, or like, aha, this 6 + 4 = 10. It's like having an aha moment, Sagittarius, where you realize everything that's gone wrong and you can like sort of put your finger on it, put the spotlight on it, and understand it yourself so that now it doesn't have power over you. Time to heal. This is a very spiritual card. This is Kundalini energy. It could be like the demons within, but at the same time, it's also this energy of this massive fire power that sits in your gut, and you're using that power for your own good, to cleanse you, to cleanse your system, to cleanse your system of all those things that sat there and infected it and infested it, sort of cleanse your household from those things that have tried to harm you, or yeah, just like energies from the past that have built up and maybe made your system toxic. It's literally you could be literally doing a cleanse too. You could be going on a retreat, sort of going into steam baths, smoke houses, literally cleansing yourself spiritually, so that you heal and you can move on. And that's that energy, that beautiful energy of two as well. It's finding a way to combine two extremes. This is Gemini energy, taking off, moving forward, making progress, seeing the way through. So it's healing. It's healing that is helping you. This is energy of 55, also 10. 10, the ending of a cycle, coming to a conclusion, wrapping things up so that you can move on. So this is a long-standing cycle, long-standing pattern or struggle or discourse between you and something else, or a situation that was difficult. It's all coming up to the surface and washing away. This is the end of it. This is the time is right for all of it to sort of be debunked and laid to rest. Hold on, I want to flip the camera angle around to review the cards with you. Hold on. Now, for some of you, this might be like really good news, and for some of you, it might be too good to be true, but I honestly feel like most of you feel, Sagittarius, like this is already in you. You know this is what's coming because you're ready. You have defined this moment. You have literally, this was meant to happen now. This is divine intervention to sort of save your life, for the truth to finally come out after so many battles, but it's because of you. And I want you to know it, that that's how much it is because of you. It's because you let go and you decided to just not get involved in the BS and not let them drag you down. Like, it was almost like you were getting into bull doo-doo too deep. And it's almost like it could have been somebody else's doo-doo. You know what I'm saying? It's like you were just letting it drag you down and taking it personally, making it an emotional reaction. Here, you're just staying emotionally light. You're staying on the surface. In other words, you're taking your emotions out of it. You'll be able to see both sides. You're not going after somebody or attacking them. No more accusations. No more egging people on or somebody is, like I said, you can flip these energies. So somebody is no longer doing this to you, but I think it's more you taking yourself out of it and saying, I can't put my energy in this anymore. It's draining me. I know which way I want to go, and it's forward. And that's how you're leaving it behind. But that's why you're making these breakthroughs, Sagittarius. These breakthroughs are coming because you literally adjusted your insides. And this is what it was. You literally gut-wrenched yourself to a point where you purged it all and you got rid of it. And literally, that's why you're making progress. You sort of just released the toxins, released the toxicity, and more or less took over this air sign energy of just logic and pragmatism and objectivity. Okay, how do we move forward? And it really was your efforts that helped to create this momentum or progress. This could also be very sexual energy that's healing you, being able to combine with somebody, finding somebody that you really connect with and that you just kind of like just want to entwine yourself with. This could also be sexual energy that ends up ending in conception, because this could be my conception. This is my conception card. This and the rabbits, for obvious reasons. But there's definitely this energy of the double helix and two becoming one, or DNA or genetics, like coming together. But this could also be medical healing. So actually a physical ailment finally being healed or coming to an end, or yeah, actually just being healed and you helping it along spiritually, getting some sort of breakthrough truth or understanding of your circumstance or situation or information that you needed to help yourself. But this is really a beautiful time that you basically orchestrated yourself. You set this up, Sagittarius. So, you know, good on you. You're finally finding, it's not just about healing. It's not just about letting go. It's what letting go has done for you. This is that 3D payback of letting go has finally sort of resolved things. Yeah, let's get a deeper reading. If you care to join me, let's go to the extended. That link is right below, and it will include, of course, your romance reading. I'll see you guys over there.